Before we can build useful graphics for our project, we need to understand the basic functions in Graphics Editor. In this video section, I'll briefly demonstrate the low-level tools that will be expanded on in the later sections. We won't even go into the web HMI yet. We'll just edit our graphics. Also, I won't demonstrate every single tool and option, but rather just enough to get you started. If you need more information, the System Guide section, Reference, Graphics Reference, Graphics Editor References, contains everything I'm showing here in greater detail. With that out of the way, let's open Graphics Editor. Many of the tools and concepts here are similar to other vector graphics tools, like Visio, Illustrator, or Inkscape. The files we edit here are in TGML format, TAC Vista Graphics Markup Language. If I save this file, it's located by default in the TGML folder of my project. We'll see later how this directory structure is important. Below the menu, the main toolbar gives us our main tools and objects to drop on the page. Selecting any of these changes the functions in the toolbar below it to match. To the far right, we have a link to our one-line connection debugger, which will come in handy much later. Centered in the page is our primary display area, where we create our graphics. On the right side of our menu, there are three different view modes for this pane. Most of our work will be in design mode, which gives us a graphical layout of our page. Source displays our raw TGML code, which is an XML variant and can easily be edited by hand. Finally, the preview button allows us to write test values into the page and verify its operation. The other pages around the display are laid out this way by default. The left side of the page holds the equipment, component, and snippet libraries that we can use to quickly populate a page with pre-developed materials. The right side holds the object tree and selecting an object enables its properties page. There is also a binding tab that is enabled automatically when the equipment tab is deselected. The reason for this will be clear when we start automatically binding components. Last, the test pane is used to write values into the preview. These panes can be changed by grabbing their tabs and moving them to different locations. Take the Properties tab. My preference is to move it to the middle right of the page by snapping it to this lower box. However, I can also drag it out as a floating window. It can even be added to the right pane or added as a new pane at the top. You may also auto-hide a pane with the thumbtack icon at the top right. Or close it entirely if it's not needed. To bring it back, just select it in the View menu. There are other tools here that aren't displayed by default, and we'll look at some of them later. When you have the window laid out the way you like, click on File, Settings, Save Settings, to leave this as the default. This will put you at a good starting point to add some simple objects to your page, which we will do in the next video. Until then, thank you.